Here's what we know this morning. The memorial outside her Upper East Side apartment continues to grow. Fans, friends, loved ones lighting candles, leaving notes, and sharing memories. Her family says the funeral will be at Temple Emmanuel. And as we've been saying, Rivers always wanted a lavish, over-the-top funeral. At the same time, the State Department has launched an investigation into Yorkville endoscopy. That's the outpatient clinic where Rivers went into cardiac arrest. The clinic is said to be cooperating fully and reportedly has no health violations or complaints against it, but there's going to be a full investigation. And on a final note, Rivers' popular E! Show, Fashion Police, has been put on hiatus for the time being. So we wanted to leave you with this clip of her, right?
Yes.
Where she's actually talking about how she wants to be remembered. So let's roll that.
When I die, and yes, Melissa, the day will come, and yes, Melissa, everything's still in your name. I want my funeral to be a huge showbiz affair with lights and cameras and action. I want craft services. I want paparazzi.
She wants Meryl Streep
to cry in five
different languages. She wants to be wearing Valentino. She wants to have a toe tag made by Harry Winston.
Yeah.
I mean, she goes on and on, and she wants the wind blowing like Beyonce. She wanted to be fabulous.
Yeah, I mean, such a fabulous life, and even we've been talking about this, even when she was in a coma, still getting makeup and hair done. I mean, it just tells you about this woman. Jeffrey Gurian, he's a comedian. He knows a lot more than all of us do about Joan because he worked with her. He actually wrote jokes for her back in the day. Also, we're joined by Katrina Metzeliotis, an editor at HollywoodLife.com. Thank you so much, both of you, for coming in. And Jeffrey, I want to start with you because I think all of us, we've watched Joan over the years. Our parents have watched Joan. Our grandparents have watched Joan. So we know what she's like when she's on stage. But what is she like when she's off?
The exact opposite of what you see on stage.
Really?
She could be caustic on stage and acerbic, and she was the kindest and sweetest and gentlest person. I just loved her. I had a crush on Joan Rivers, which I had never said before, but it's the truth. When I first met her, back in the 90s, I met her as the result of writing for a Friar's Roast. And her manager called me and said, Joan would like to talk to you about writing for her. And at the time, I was still a cosmetic dentist. That was my other field. And I went to her house, and the doorman said to me, you have to wait a minute, because she just sprained her ankle, and she's in a lot of pain. And I said to myself, wow, maybe I could write her a prescription for painkillers. It'll be perfect, and then she'll hire me. And then when I finally went up to her house, I realized that she didn't know about my other field because she introduced me to everyone as Mr. Gurian. Well, I'm writing for her for months, and one day I get a call from Las Vegas, and my nurse in my office knew only disturb me if it's something in show business. So she came to me and she said, Dr. Rivers is on the phone.
And
so I came to the phone, and Joan said to me, what do you do during the day? And her assistant had seen me on TV, and she knew I did this other thing. And I said, well, I work. And she said, well, obviously you work, but what is it that you do? And I said, is this concerning the vicious rumor going around that I'm a dentist? I said, I've heard of accusing people of a lot of things, but that's really low. And she laughed and she said, why didn't you ever tell me? And I said, because no one hires you because you're a dentist. They hire you in spite of it. And we got along so well.
Well, let's talk about what people are going to remember, because, her funeral is expected this weekend, Temple Emmanuel. Are we going to hear and see the celebrities that she wanted? Is that going to be Melissa's tribute to her mom?
I think we're going to see it. It's going to be exactly fabulous, just the way Joan wanted it. And I really think we're going to see that. There's been such an outpouring of support for Melissa, for the family, and so many people are paying tribute to Joan, and I'm sure they're going to flock to pay their last respects as
well. Yeah, I mean, we talked about so many people that she was so close with. She never forgot a name.
Never.
She made everybody that she sat next to very, very important.
She made everybody feel important and welcome. She would hug you. You just felt very special being in her presence.
So, do you think she'll be in that Valentino dress?
I hope so. It's very interesting because for someone who was so brash, she was also so gracious behind the scenes. And although she poked fun at so many celebrities, so many people have the utmost respect for her. And Joan made fun of herself above all else.
What about Melissa? What about Melissa this morning?
I feel so horrible for her. I don't know. I can't even imagine what she's going through. It's hard enough to deal with tragedy when you're a private person, but when your whole life is in public, I can't even imagine what it's like.
But that
for
wasn't
her.
A mother-daughter relationship. It was a friendship. It was
friends.
A partnership. It was more than that. They loved to hate each other, hate to love each other. They talked to each other every day, which I didn't know about in some shape or form. She flew out every week to go to L.A.
They mm-hmm. were connected on so many different levels. It went beyond that typical mother-daughter bond. They worked together. They loved together. They cried together. And our sources are telling us at HollywoodLife.com that she's just heartbroken and her world is shattered. But she has a close support system, and she just can't imagine being in this position.
From her publicists, all of the people that Joan surrounded her by, they all worked for her for years.
For years. She had the same people around her for a long time.
I know.
Jocelyn, her assistant, and Judy Katz,
who's been on the show so many times, you know.
And I know that you now, for the rest of your life, are going to treasure the fact that you were in that orbit for years.
Oh, for sure. This picture that she sent to me is one of my most treasured possessions. This was, I don't even know where to hold it up, but.
Yeah, you can just hold it up. It's right there. That's fine. We'll get a shot of it.
She wrote this to me. She wrote, Jeff, you're so talented. Good luck, Joan Rivers. This was when back from the 90s when we first met. And it's just really one of my most treasured possessions, especially now.
Yeah, especially now. Yeah. Thank you so much for being here and giving us your perspective. Of course, you can go to pixlove.com/Joan Rivers. Photo galleries, quotes from her many years of making us laugh so much more.
Yeah.